going on, everybody? It's TG Smooth back with some more Battleborn Legendary builds, and today we're going to be looking into Oscar Mike again. I know, I already did one, but it was different, and it wasn't completely all Legendary, so, yeah, anyways, I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a pretty awesome day. If you do find this video helpful or you like it in any way, don't forget to show your support and smash that thumbs up button for me and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this and share the video as you see fit. Yeah. Three most important things say in a video. I don't know why I'm talking funny. It's late. I took a muscle relaxer because my shoulder is all jacked up. Anyways, going into this, level 1 left trigger, of course. Level 2 left trigger. Level 3, it depends. I mean, I kind of like the long range scope, and then sometimes I like the red dot sight. It just depends on the people. If there's smaller characters like Rendi and Alani, I definitely like the range scope. The zoom on it makes it easier to get crits on them. Anyways, level 4 left trigger, level 5 right trigger. You can try it with Y. I find out you do more damage with the tactical rounds than you do with the critical damage. Anyways, level 6 right trigger, level 7 Y, level 8 right trigger, level 9 Y, and that is just kind of to like ambush them. And I am talking really funny tonight, and I apologize for that. Anyways, and then level 10 in this video, I actually wanted it to follow me. The Y, I know it does less damage, but actually no, it don't even. It's just a smaller area. But I messed up and went with right trigger, or else this would have went a hell of a lot better whenever you can stealth and still call it in, and just people really don't know what's happening. So I really jacked that up in this video. However, it's still a good match, so going into gear, what was I using? Well, here it is. So Magdaemon, reload speed, crit hit damage, and chance for non-crit to deal critical damage. Same with Stable Executioner, recoil, crit hit damage, and chance for non-criticals to deal critical damage. And then the Vow of Zealous Fury, attack speed, crit hit damage, and then some more attack speed on top of that. So you shoot a hell of a lot faster. It's really useful on ranged characters. It does make the fire rate go up, so just bear that in mind. And another thing I want to bring up in this video is you will see me get this build. Now, many people's been criticizing me, oh, you know, Smooth, go for the buildables and all that. Well, you'll see in this video how fast you can destroy these if you just clear the lane, harass the people in that lane, chase them off enough to go up, destroy their accelerator, their thumper turret, their supply station, whatever it may be, and then they're just wasting shards and they're giving you experience. Now, the thing about that is you do get experience from these. It may not even be that much, but still, when they're easily destroyed and you're just feeding the other team experience, then I don't really find it useful. Some people may. I mean, sometimes those stinger turrets do save a life, and if the lane's clear, they will help you do some damage. However, a smart team's always going to take those out first. They should have their range characters, their lane clears, taking out those turrets and those accelerators and those thumpers. And this was a pre-made team that I played against in this video, so they were really well coordinated. They did the same thing I was doing to them. They was taking out the thumpers, the supply stations, everything, and it was just back and forth. And the thing is you're wasting so much shards. I have a legendary build, and you'll see me go up against Oscar Mike, the other Oscar Mike on the other team, a few times in this video, and you'll see that his build is all epics. I think the whole team had epics. Some had a few legendaries, like their Galea, but you'll see me and Oscar Mike dish it out around the same level and how much of a draw it is. And that's kind of because that lane I was used to being by myself on, so I didn't trust the randoms on my team to come help me if I needed it. And you'll see that. There's a lot of times Oscar Mike's there, and then Rendy or other people kick over there. I think Reyna helped me a little bit. But anyways, it just proves my point. I mean, get the better gear and just be done with it. I mean, not everybody on your team's running legendaries, so leave that to them to use those buildables. I mean, that's primarily an assassin's job, is to gather those shards, because they're really supposed to be set up for kills. And then we are barbarians, go on somewhere. And then the rest of the time they're not on the lane, they can gather shards and get buildables, or somebody with, you know, a item that buildables cost less, that can be their job, their role specifically in the team, if you want that to happen while the lane's clear. Of course, the lane must be clear. So just keep that in mind, guys. I mean, everybody has a different playstyle. Mine's more for fun than competitive, and I did not bust my ass off for these legendaries to not at least try them out and have fun with them, because the bonuses they give, I mean, like, look at this. Burning Sunset, once every 30 seconds, negate all damage from an enemy skill. That includes alts. So if a Rendy uses her ult on you, you negate the damage if that procs. I mean, why is that not worth the 1800 shards? Some of these items are very well worth it, like the Boots of the Brute. Irreplaceable in a melee character's build. I mean, movement speed, attack speed, and melee attacks will slow an enemy once every 3 seconds. They're irreplaceable. If you're a melee character and you don't have those on, you're probably wrong. That's what I'm saying. Unless you grind it for it, and of course you didn't get it. But if you have them sitting in your inventory and you're not using them on a melee character, you probably need to. Anyways, guys, I'm done ranting for now. The criticism is real. I hope you guys understand my side. I play for fun, not really competitively. I win as pretty much a lot. I mean, 473 matches, and I won 310 of those 473 matches. Most of those, I've been rocking legendary builds. So either I'm really skilled, or I don't know, because I play on randoms, with randoms. I play with one guy, maybe two. Not all the time, they're not always on. So a lot is pickup groups, and I still win. So obviously I'm doing something right. And I haven't seen teammates use a lot of buildables. So, and most of those losses are from figuring out characters or playing with randoms, and, you know, them being weak and surrendering. So that's where a lot of my losses come from. Anyways, done ranting. I hope you guys have a good day. Enjoy the video. It's a pretty interesting build, but for now, guys, this is TG Smooth out, and remember, stay smooth.
Incinerators and destroy enemy minions before they reach their own. The bigger the minion, the more points you'll earn by sacrificing. The first team to reach 500 points achieves victory.
The other guys will be killed!
Lighting this up in 3, 2, 1, go.
Paydays, just a few bucks.
A wave of minions has been deployed.
Send him packing!
Relinquish your level! Be controlled!
Won't see me coming!
Burn the world to ashes!
Tango down!
Back
nobody, by myself. That is how the Tom do. What you gonna do, me? Now the shard horn begins. Huh? I'll get it right here.
Approves of this battle and is live tweeting it as he speaks.
Hey, tough guy, it's you and me.
Something, blood bank!
Appeasement at 50%. Our minion altars have been relocated.
Get to right!
Didn't anybody warn you not to piss me off?
Hostile giant minion en route to the enemy altar. Our enemies have spawned a giant minion. Stop it.
Deploying explosive thingy. Let's do this.
Enemy minion altars have been relocated.
Thank you.
Giant minion deployed. Shepherded to our altar. Meltdown. The enemy has deployed a giant minion. Destroy it. Hostile giant minion en route to the enemy altar.
Never had a chance!
Have spawned a giant minion. Stop it! The enemy has deployed a giant minion. Destroy it!
Be ready.
Enemy forces at half strength.
Really, your best?
Hostile giant minion en route to the enemy altar. Our enemies have spawned a giant minion. Stop it! Giant minion en route to the enemy altar. The enemy has deployed a giant minion. Destroy it. Giant minion. See it safely to our altar. Hostile giant minion en route to the enemy altar. We're nearing maximum appeasement. Keep up the pace. Minute to meltdown.
Thank you.
power play. Enemy forces at 40% strength. Only one hostile remains. You should kill them too.